He inhaled, a sharp, painful gasp, before the convulsions took over and the crying began. Ruth Christina waited. "Has she told you about my proposal?" She knew that Yetta hadn't managed to get that far, but she wanted to take his mind off the situation and onto the solution, and as soon as possible, away from the despair. But she wasn't sure if he had even heard her. He just stood there, shaking. Ruth Christina had never liked Jens Christian. On the occasions he had come home while she was visiting Yetta, he'd never greeted her, never smiled at her, just had that look on his face, the disappointment that Yetta was friends with people like her. Ruth Christina knew it. She had encouraged Yetta more than once to stand up for herself, not to be so submissive and obedient, but Jens Christian had some kind of power over her. Sometimes one look was all it took, and Yetta would know what he wanted her to do. Even now, as he stood there in front of her, his upper body sagging forwards, trembling, hunched over as if someone had punched him, Ruth Christina found it impossible to muster up any compassion for him. A solution. Progression. They didn't have much time. She didn't have much time. "I know of a way out of this," Ruth Christina said. "But for this to work, you have to do exactly what I say." Chapter 73. As I said, I had my own child at that time, a gorgeous baby girl, but I was never allowed to see her. Ruth Christina stopped herself and looked down at her feet. "And I thought they were going to restrict my visits even more,"